Hello friends, I'm Monica. Today I'm talking about this very beautiful plant. See this plant. This plant, it adds bright colors to your garden in winters. And the see the pom-pom like these. See the pom-pom like flowers. They range in color from yellow to orange, different colors of pink, different colors of red, white. They comes in several colors. So see the flowers, they look like rose flowers, even more beautiful than rose flowers. And the flowers, they come in bunches. See the inflorescence bunches, they come in bunches and different varieties. It is single, it is two or four whorls of petals in this. They are multi whorls of petals. They look very beautiful. And the leaves are also, see the leaves are also very beautiful. So this is very beautiful plant. Now we start with the soil. Soil, it grows well in well drained soil that means absorbs moisture without stagnation. Means it holds, or it holds some moisture but allows extra water to drain out through the drainage hole. So how to make well-drained soil? For well-drained soil, take one part of soil of your area, one part of sands, river sand, and one part of cow dung manure or vermicompost, one tablespoon of mustard cake powder, and one tablespoon of neem cake powder, and add two tablespoons of bone meal. As it is a flowering plant, and flowering plants, they flowering plant as well as it is a plant grown from bulb. Any plant which is which grows from bulbs requires lots of phosphorus and potassium. So that's why to fulfill its need of extra phosphorus, we add bone meal to the soil mixture. This soil mixture is for a normal 12-inch pot. In addition to all these things, add 2 tablespoons of chalk powder in the soil mixture, because this plant likes a slightly acidic soil, acidic to neutral soil, means near to neutral soil. And when we add any organic manure to the soil mixture, it makes the soil mixture acidic, because these organic manures, cow dung manure and vermicompost, they are acidic in nature, so they make the soil acidic. To reduce the acidity of the soil and make it near to neutral, we add chalk powder. If you don't add chalk powder to your soil mixture for this plant, for these plants, ranunculus, it won't flower as good as it should be. For these plants, for ranunculus, select a site in your garden which receives, where these plants can receive 5 to 6 hours of sunlight. They prefer 5 to 6 hours of sunlight. Otherwise, they won't bloom to their fullest as we want them to be. So, they require 5 to 6 hours of sunlight. That's all. Then we come to, we have talked about the soil, the sunlight requirement. Now we come to water. Water keep the soil moist. Water these plants only when the upper layer of soil is slightly dry. So let the soil dry between two watering. Keep your soil slightly moist, not dry. And this is the water requirement of the plant. Then we come to fertilization. Fertilization, fertilize these any flowering plant which you have in your garden. Any flowering plant, they require liquid fertilizer every 15 days. Because as you know, these are annual plants. And annual plants, they bloom, they give flowers. So to produce more and more flowers, they require more fertilizer. more of phosphorus, more of potassium in comparison to nitrogen. So we should fertilize these plants every 15 days with liquid fertilizer. Why liquid fertilizer? Because liquid fertilizer reaches their roots quickly in comparison to the dry fertilizer, or we can say slow release fertilizer. Slow release fertilizer releases slowly and reaches to their roots. But we want them to receive more of nutrition every 15 days, or even every week also you can give. If your plants are blooming profusely, giving very big amount of flowers, you can give them, as in chrysanthemums, we fertilize them every week also. So how to make this liquid fertilizer? If you are you want to make chemical liquid fertilizer, take 1 liter of water, dissolve 1 small teaspoon of superphosphate and 1 small teaspoon of potash and half or 1/4 teaspoon of micronutrient powder in that. Dissolve these things properly and then give this solution to your plant. This is a complete food for them. As we take, when we need extra energy, we take glucose, we dissolve glucose in water and then take it. The same way, we are giving them that energy to produce more flowers. Now we come to propagation of this plant. I think, according to my suggestion, it is better to purchase plants from the nursery. But if you want to grow it at home on your own, you can purchase tubers or bulbs of these plants from any nursery or from online shops. Those tubers are not exactly like bulbs or tubers. They look like claws of some birds, like roots of some plants. You can purchase them and grow them, keeping pointed side upside upwards, and set it 2 inches deep in the soil, and soil will be same as I described here. So this was all about ranunculus, this beautiful plant. If you like my video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Okay, friends, bye.